This tutorial is designed to show students how to generate a line graph where you display two variables on the same graph. What we'll also be doing is showing students how to actually use two alternative y-axes, one on the left-hand side of the graph, the other on the right-hand side of the graph. This is especially useful when variables use distinctly different scales of measurement. To emphasize this, I'll use two variables, GDP and investment share. GDP, in this case, is measured in euros. Investment share is measured in percentages. GDP ranges from around 13,000 up to about 43,000, while investment share ranges from in the 20% up to mid-30%. To insert a line graph with these two different variables on it, first we'll select the Insert tab and choose a line chart. We'll select a 2D line graph, and once the chart area appears, we will right-click on the chart area and choose Select Data. Once this screen appears, we can add our different data series. We'll first add our legend series. And the first variable we will add is GDP. In the Series Name tab, we can select GDP. And in the Series Value tab, we can select from cell B2 down to cell B19. So all of our GDP measures, and select OK. We can see along the actual horizontal axis here that we have numbers instead of years. To change that, we select the horizontal category and edit, and we then select cells A2 to A19, so our years. We can now see that we've placed years along our horizontal axis. To place our actual investment share on the graph as well, we simply go back to our legend entry series and select Add. We choose our second series name, which in this case is investment share. We also choose our series values, so from cell C2 to cell C19. We select OK, and we can also add the yearly data for this as well, selecting OK. When we go and look at our graph, we can see that we have two hugely different scales, so our red line for investment share is just lined up along the bottom of the graph, and we can't tell any of the variation in it. So what we can do is left-click on this red line, and then right-click, and select Format Data Series. The first thing we want to click is Series Options, and then we wish to select Secondary Axis, and Close. This adds a secondary Y-axis label here, which contains the information for investment share. What we can now see is investment share going up and down, and it's much more easy to interpret, as opposed to a straight line going along the bottom of the graph. In this instance, we ensure that we keep our legend here, which tells us that GDP is the blue line and investment share is the red line. We can then select a chart layout option from our drop-down menu, and we can label our chart, giving our chart a title, in this case Figure 3, Investment Share, and GDP, and we can give our axes titles as well. In this case we will call this Year, and we will label our left axis GDP in Euro. That completes the video tutorial. Students can access other tutorials from the Blackboard site to aid them in EC3115.